I'm James. Today is May 1st, 2020. Welcome to your BHS News Distance Learning Special, Volume 4. Today, we are going to begin our series called People We Miss from BHS. Welcome, Mr. Jantz.
How we doing, everybody? Good to see people's faces again. So hope everyone's doing well.
Hi, I'm Nick. So first question, Mr. Jantz, what are you missing the most about Bethpage High School?
First of all, I know who you are, but thanks for the introduction. Yeah. I miss you. I miss all of you. I miss Mr. Malassi. I miss the staff. I miss the just the normalcy of the routine. I was actually in the building the other day and heard the bell ring, and I still said, what should I do? You know, so I'm still, hopefully it comes back quick, but I just miss being there. I miss sports. Devastated that spring sports was canceled. But I really just miss all of you. That makes Bethpage High School such a great place.
Hello, everyone. It's Mertz. Mr. Jantz, what is the best way you found to stay occupied and busy during quarantine?
All right. How we doing, Mertz? Working. I'm working like crazy. I tell my neighbors that Bethpage High School is currently in my office. So we have a lot of meetings, a lot of stuff to do, and things take 3, 4, or 5 times longer to get done. You know, even writing a letter to parents or to staff. It takes longer just because you don't have everything that you usually have at work. But besides that, hanging out with my family a lot. I have 2 kids. My son Harrison is in 2nd grade and my daughter Lucy's in kindergarten. We've been watching a lot of Disney Plus movies. I am very sick of the Lindsay Lohan anthology.
Mr. Jantz, how have BHS students been adjusting to the stay inside lifestyle?
I hope well. You know, I think their bedtimes have been thrown off. After talking to a lot of teachers, it seems like a lot of work is submitted between the hours of 12:30 and 3:30 a.m. So it seems like everyone's kind of quickly evolved into college students. You know, we miss all of you. We hope you're doing well. We know there's a lot of families out there that have been negatively impacted by the virus. And it's terrible. You know, I get heartbreaking emails every day, and our support staff is working really hard to help those people. But I hope the students are doing okay.
Hi, Mr. Jantz. What are your top 5 list of shows or movies to recommend?
All right. I don't know if I can give you 5 in order, but I watched Succession on HBO. Tremendous. One of the best shows I've seen in a long time. And Luther, I don't know if anyone's ever seen Luther. It's a BBC show with Idris Elba. They released the new season probably a while ago, but I've just got to that. And we've been doing a lot of kid movies. Diary of a Wimpy Kid, 1 through 49. They just keep making these movies. I think the kid is like 40 now, but still having fun with that. And my kids are obsessed with the show from Universal TV called Get Out of My Room. Has anyone seen that? So that's like a kid room makeover show. So now my children have all these terrible ideas of how I should redo their rooms. So watched some good shows with my wife and then a lot of movies with my kids. Hope that answers your question.
Hi, it's Angela. Anything you want to say to the seniors who've had their final year shortened?
This is probably the toughest part. You know, I know it's been tough for everybody, 9th through 11th grade, but senior sports, all the senior events. You know, I guess it is a little comforting that it's happening all over the world. It's not just the Bethpage issue, thank God, you know. But it's been really hard. I have met with Mr. Healy and Mr. Toko with the senior leaders once a week, and we are plotting out events. We're hoping by late June even, or July or August, that the government restrictions on gathering have been relaxed, so we can give them a proper send-off. Ideally, if those are relaxed and we can gather, we could do a normal graduation on the football field, whether it's July or August. We could do kind of a senior week where maybe we have a prom type event in the gym. We are fortunate in a sense because we don't rent out either the Tillis Center, a Hofstra, or a larger space for graduation. We do it right on the football field. So there are a lot of schools in a bit of a more difficult position for planning those events. So ideally, our goal is we're going to hold out as long as we can and give the seniors some proper send-off. It might look a little different, might be a little bit warmer because it's July or August, but that's our goal. Hopefully, they just hang in there. Who would have ever expected this? When we left on March 13th, I thought we'd be back before Easter break. I remember saying to Mr. Tocco, we'll be back 3 days and then we have Easter break. And I feel like that was 3 years ago. So, you know, just hang in there and don't lose hope.
Thank you, Mr. Jantz and BHS. Stay safe. Now take a look at a video from Miss Bertolotti's classes.
Oh, hey. Remember me? I'm your English teacher. I'm so happy and grateful to be here with you today, coming at you from what I've nicknamed Studio B. Today, I'm going to tell you a little secret about how not to get off with the people that you are home with right now. Because you got to admit, we're all faced with something right now that's different. This is the first time that I could dare to say that we're all going through this, right? This is new for everyone and we're readjusting to maybe some people are working from home. You're obviously not in school right now that you're used to going to every day for a good number of hours. So we're all adjusting to doing things differently. And Eric Hoffer wrote, "In a time of drastic change, it is the learners who will inherit the future. The learned usually find themselves equipped to live in a world that no longer exists." Here we are, learning how to do things differently, to think differently, and to be different. At least different than our normal routine, what we're used to, and all that kind of stuff, right? So here we are, we're home, we're spending more time in situations that maybe we're not used to, except if it's in the summer or whatever, and tensions can get a little tough, right? Sometimes you just want to be like, to those people. A little word of advice, a little B-ism for you. Would you rather be right or would you rather be happy? I'm going to opt for happy. And I know like 14, 15, 16, 17 year old me would have been like, get me out of here. And I probably would have been at times a nightmare to be, do we say quarantined? And I don't even know if that's the right word, but to be working from home with. So knowing that, taking that breath, if you get into those moments, those situations, those conversations where you either are catching them get on your nerves or you're getting on their nerves, take a beat, take a breath, ask yourself, do you want to be right or do you want to be happy? If that applies to the situation. If you know you need to step away, if you catch yourself in one of those moods and no matter what someone's saying to you, they could be like, do you want waffles? And you just want to be like, just say, I need to go do my English homework now. And consider this your English homework. To step away, as long as that's cool with the older people who are in charge of you, to step away from the situation, maybe step into the next room, take that good old deep breath. Know that, again, we're all trying things and learning things differently. Give yourself some grace and it's okay to step away. And if you do mess up, if you do snap at somebody, own it, apologize. If somebody snaps at you, recognize that they too are adjusting to this new situation, okay? So I do hope that I see you again sometime soon. I'll be popping back on here throughout our weeks, whatever it will be, to share some things with you, sometimes of this nature. We'll probably have some assignments out there. If you're watching this from a fourth period world, know that Mrs. Brosnan says hello too. And we will talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.